What's up, everybody? My name is Coalfire, and welcome back to Hellblade. I want to start this episode out by asking you guys, how the hell are you doing? This game is some heavy shit. Some really, really heavy shit. The gameplay mechanics on its own, I think, would make a fantastic game. Ninja Theory has done a phenomenal job with creating an interesting world with solid mechanics in a very, very immersive way. But the fact that they brought on the neuroscientists to so well portray a mental illness of this sort gives this game a ridiculous amount of depth that you don't see elsewhere. But yeah, how are you guys? Throw it down in the comments. I want to know. I really do. But hold on, my face is being a little funky. Is that better? I think that's better. So yeah, let's dive back into this. Let's go. So I did figure out a few other things about the game when I was... Actually, I'm going to go into controls. Run toggle. There we go. So that way we can move around a little bit faster. But there is an evade mechanic that I just completely failed to figure out. Until actually reading the controls. Younger. In the menu.
She would lay in the grass and stare at the clouds. And then she saw them. Elusive. Shifting faces. After a while, she could see the faces everywhere. In the trees. The mountains. Caves.
Well, we came out of the same door that we went in. That's weird. I don't know how that all links together. I mean, I get that guy's the, one of the deities of illusion. But, wow. And it's so much brighter now. There's a lot less feeling of such an oppressive atmosphere.
I wonder. Can you see the faces too? They're there.
That one kind of looks like a skull.
If you look for them.
I don't know. Hi, face. Whoa.
Senua, you have the sight. Just like I do. Once you can see into the underworld, the underworld and all the souls within it will see you. Don't be afraid when they speak to you. I will always be here to guide you.
Did you see her? That was her mother, Galina. She was a priestess, a healer. She taught Senua to see the weave that binds the world together. And it was beautiful. It was a time before the darkness. But when it did come, it first came for her mother. Senua still sees her face from time to time, hidden in the world. Like she's still watching over.
So, something that just kind of struck me was that not only is this game taking time to show the perspective of somebody with this mental illness, but they're also showing an old perspective of how people with a condition like this could be viewed. someone with these hallucinations in a spiritual standpoint, as in being able to look into other worlds, to see the underworld. There's the dodge.
Remember your training.
A little out of practice. No, is that a death? Is that a death? Ugh! Fuck! Fuck me.
She's dead.
Oh shit. Okay, so I actually have to interact with that. It was responding when I was tapping A to get back up. But I didn't realize that until the very end. Can't block that. Oh, wow. Okay, so. Oh, I'll let this go for a bit.
Surt, the fire giant has answered. He comes from a land older than mankind. And the Northmen call upon his flaming sword to raise their enemies to the ground. Find him, Senua. And spill his blood.
Druth, you're a little sadistic, man. Okay, so...
She found the wretched old fool on her way back from the wilds. An outcast. He was badly burnt all over. She took pity on him, for he was not long for this world. Like her, who spoke of his own darkness. The Northmen.
Yeah, so... What I figured out was the mirror on my hip is a little bit of a gauge for how much focus I have, which I can use to both clarify and slow down enemies. So if they're like phantasms, I can make them real. Or if they're moving too quickly or blocking like that, I can get around them and slow down time. Why are they telling me to run? That shit is so freaking satisfying once you figure out how to use all the little bits and pieces of it. And it's so much deeper than it looks.
I can still smell it.
Okay.
A sweet, sickly stench of burning human flesh.
Druth, man.
And I still hear their cries carried in the wind.
Okay, I'm looking for, like, New York.
Them too, Senua?
Yes, I heard their screams, and I still hear them now.
No.
There's one. Looks potentially to be like one of these guys. But I need something short to go up through the middle. Man, I think this may be one of my favorite combat systems in any game so far. Oh. Ah, there's a pole. Beautiful. It just has so much
the path
weight.
To Helheim is sealed for the living, but you already walk amongst the dead. Look towards the gate, and you will see that it has opened. When they first came to my lands, I knew enough of their tongue to beg for mercy, and they took me as a slave. I wish now that they had slaughtered me like the others. I rode their storm of fire, death, slavery to many lands. This darkness you speak of? I know it well.
And I'm still here to fight it.
Truth, man. Been through a lot, dude. Alrighty. I'm stuck. Oh, come on. Let me out. Let me out. Let me out.
Watch out.
Oh, fuck. No. There we go. Awesome. Now that I figured that shit out. Come on.
Defend yourself. Stop.
help!
Don't let them surround you!
Get out of the way!
Can I not block that? I wonder. Oh, come on.
They're winning!
Too fast.
Oh, is that it? Man! Man! Ooh, doggy.
When you see a fire gate of Surt, know that only a sacrifice will stoke the fires of Muspel and let the dead walk through.
Find the fire, Senua, to follow the path to Surt.
Okay. So, do I do something with these? Oh, I completely missed this.
It's this
I'm sorry, do I have to burn myself to get through? About acknowledging the suffering of others?
It was everywhere. The pyre. Surt is through there.
He's waiting for her.
You can't get through.
How will she get through?
She'll need to find another way.
Because it seems
find your own path.
The first guy.
this all boils away.
Find your own way.
You just have to find it. That's his name. It's all about the world is not always as it seems. You can't take things at face value.
Tell this story. Before the Earth was created, there was a world called Muspel. Because it was in the south, it was bright and hot, flaming, burning. Sparks that flew out from Muspel became the stars. Other sparks melted ice in the frozen world of Niflheim.
Oh, man.
She needs to find it. Another fire sacrifice.
Find the fire, Senua, to follow the path to Surt.
From what I read up about Valravn,
she'll never find it. She'll never make her way.
The portrayal of him in this was not too far off.
Everything will burn.
There were some artistic liberties taken.
Concentrate on where you're going. She needs to remember the path.
Everything will burn. Then how will she find the way back?
She won't. She won't be able to tell.
Oh. So it's all about being able to find your way back through pain. I might be reading way too deep into this stuff, but for a game with the types of messages that this one has...
The Northmen made fire sacrifices, burning slaves like me to reveal the path to Surt. I searched for meaning in their suffering, in their eyes. But they just screamed like helpless pigs.
Okay, first, before we start this, let's see... Can we drop here? It would appear so. And we're going right through there. Cool. So we have our path planned out. Alright! Round two! All right, let's go, let's go, let's go. Whoa, what the hell was that? Ooh, yeah.
Do your gods answer your prayers, Senua? I asked the gods for mercy, all of them, even theirs. None answered. In the end, I set myself free. Defy the gods, Senua! Find your own path, like I find mine!
My gods abandoned me! I am alone.
Yeah, so I'm starting to wonder if each of these gods and each of these trials is meant to be a mythological interpretation and representation of different aspects of overcoming mental illness.
The Northmen say that the defender of Muspel is called Surt, the foremost of the fire giants. His name means the Black One, because he is like something burnt. The Northmen believe that he sits at the border of Muspel with his flaming sword, and at the end of the world he will leave his post. He will travel to Asgard and Midgard, waging war against all the gods. He will be victorious, and then burn the whole world with fire.
And I did do a little bit of reading back into Norse mythology and the concepts of, like, Hel and Valhalla. And from what I could glean, and don't take my word as truth, if you're interested in it, please go read it yourself, is that Hel was for the dishonorable, dead, and not in the sense that, like, they did something bad in life or anything like that, but more along the lines of they didn't die an honorable death. What am I missing there? Maybe I just found the path I need to use to get out of here. Let's go up here and grab this first. While Valhalla, which was reserved for people who died an honorable death, who fell in battle, while Hell was for people who died...
The Northmen of Hell worshipped the Devourers, insatiable gods of darkness. I come from Erin, Senua, where I once followed my own gods, the Tuatha De Danann.
Why did you abandon your gods?
Senua, I was a man of knowledge, not a warrior. To survive, I did things. Bad things. Like you, Senua. The man I once was has died. And when that happens, even gods you worship can die with you.
Oh, there it is. Yeah, Hell was for people who died of sickness and old age, people who didn't fall in battle, considered dishonorable deaths. But Hell was located below the surface of the earth in these different planes that existed, while Valhalla was located in the realm of the gods, which is a couple layers above Midgard. I can't remember the exact name of it right now. My apologies. Okay, that was a little abstract. I gotcha. Interesting, I was looking for much larger physical objects. That took me this many minutes. Moving on. Inserty cert. Uh-huh. Okay, so we're running what looks like a straight shot through, but I have a feeling that that tree is gonna fall and we're gonna have to run through the house. Is that, that forced us to go through the house to find that rune, so I suspect it was telling us that this is the pathway. Now it's a balancing section because the roof is gone. Yes, voices. I know. I'm running. I'm doing what I can. No. What's wrong? Why can't I go this way? Whoa. Oh, Jesus. Whoa! Hey now! Okay. Game. That was a little off. Say that that first death is the first death I do not feel responsible for.
You say your world has collapsed. Good. Let it collapse, and have the courage to shed your tears.
Raise your world to the prime!
My world is dead.
Only then, as with a newborn, will you see the world anew.
No, I see nothing now.
I love that the fires just spring up like that.
It's heat. Look for it. You'll never see.
Tell me truth. How did you escape your darkness?
Senua, once I found my purpose, I was no longer enslaved to the suffering I had to endure to reach it. Unclouded by fear, I could see it clearly in others. Even my captors feared the fire of Surt. And so, during one raid, I took my chance and ran, knowing that they would not follow. A fool ran into the fire. They left me for dead. Maybe they were right to. But here I am. Free.
I'm glad I found you in the wilds. I wouldn't have made it without you.
There's one. Did I make two of them right here? Oh, that would have been a cool little opportunity. Number two. Fossibiles.
The Northmen believe that the world will be destroyed someday. They call it Ragnarok. the destiny of the gods. Asgard will be attacked by Surt and the Fire Giants. A monstrous wolf will swallow the sun, and the gods will fight in vain against their enemies. There is nothing they can do to prevent it. But Odin ever seeks knowledge and magic, hoping to find a way to postpone that dark day.
No. Yeah.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. This darkness takes everything. Everyone.
Together, side by side. We always do.
This is my battle. I have to face it alone, away from here.
Where will you go?
I don't know.
For how long?
I don't know.
I believe in you. You know that. Just promise me that you will come back to me. I want you to say it. I want you to say it.
I will come back to you. I promise.
Stop him! He's getting stronger! Stop him right now! He's getting stronger!
does my nose itch right now? Oh, no, 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 no. Get up, get up, get up, get up.
Come on! Get up, get up, get the fuck up!
Get up, get up, get up, get up!
And in the end, we all fall. Even the gods have their time. Yet we still go on. Why?
I made a promise. And I will go to hell to keep it.
I die free, knowing you will carry my stories with you. I have fulfilled my quest.
Yes, you have.
No wonder darkness comes. I vow to guide you in this life and the next to fulfill yours.
Then I will see you in hell.
Be ready to face horror in the eye, as I have, to find your answers, your quest.
Yep. Everybody dies. In the end, none of it really matters, so why try it all? That great...
Druth was a troubled man. Scholar turned slave. They tortured him. Took him with them on their raids. Drove him to madness. Spreading this new form of darkness to new worlds. To my world. Senua saw a deep connection form between the Northmen and the darkness. His tales of hell were true. Then that was the source of it. She learned everything she could from him. Until she too could see what he saw.
This reminded me of the fantastic quote from The Matrix. Why do you persist, Mr. Anderson?
Because I choose to.
Yeah. So, it seems that one of our auditory hallucination voices...
Have you ever died before? Serious question. When the illusion of self is shattered, you simply cease to be. Though it may not seem that way to others, you know when it is true. You can feel it. A stranger in your own body. An imposter. And nothing is the same ever again. Senua has died before, and she will do so again. You can be sure of that.
Yeah, it seems like one of our voices is from hell. And I'm not sure if that last little cutscene that played was from a flashback, or if that was actually Druth leaving us because we killed Surt. But I'm sure we'll find out next time. I'm leaving this episode here. This game... I really do hope that I'm not reading too much into some of this stuff. But considering the themes that we have seen so far, I would not be surprised if a lot of this was meant to be extremely symbolic. And it's being told through this... Norse mythological filter in order to give the story a little bit more substance than just you have to persevere through your mental illness and you know, with Valravn, nothing is as it seems. With Surt, you have to persevere through the pain, stuff like that. But I am still absolutely loving this game. I hope you guys are enjoying it as much as I am, and really just appreciating it for what it is. I want to say thankful for Ninja Theory for creating a game like this, and I'm excited to see where else it goes. But thank you guys so much for watching. My name is Coalfire, and I will see you next time.